Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Our today lecture is upon satellite link budget analysis. The group members are Wamik Rahim, Shehwab bin Sultan Raja, and Muhammad Tahir Sadiqi. And our supervisor is Engineer Humayun Shahid. Now coming toward the general architecture of link budget analysis, we have a satellite in a space and two links, uplink and downlinks from the earth and satellite station. Now we consider gain over noise, temperature, path losses, rain attenuation. Introduction. What exactly is a link budget? A link budget is actually simple addition and subtraction of gains and losses within radio frequency link. When these gains and losses of various components are determined and summed, the result is an estimation of end-to-end system performance in the real world. To arrive at the accurate answer, factors such as the uplink power of amplifier gain and noise factors, transmit antenna gain, slant angles and corresponding atmospheric losses over distance, satellite transponder noise level and power gains, receive antenna and amplifier gains and noise factors, cable losses, adjacent satellite interference levels and climate attenuation factors must be considered. Is link budget important? A link budget is used to predict performance before the link is established. Show in advance if it will be acceptable. Show if one option is better than another. Provide a criterion to evaluate actual performance. Worst case scenario. There is some point as earth to satellite station located at the edge of coverage zone. Maximum path length from the satellite to the earth station. Low angle elevation at earth to satellite giving highest atmospheric path attenuation. And the last one is maximum rain attenuation on link, causing loss of power radiated and increase in receiving system noise temperature. Major factors in link budget analysis are downlink, effective isotropic radiated power, gain to noise temperature ratio, saturated flux density of satellite, earth station antenna, frequency, and the last one is interference. The procedure of link budget. Link budgets usually start with the transmitter power and the sum of all the gains and losses in the system, accounting for the propagation losses to find the received power. Then the noise level at the receiver is estimated, so we can take the ratio of signal power to the noise power and work out the performance of the link. This procedure is shown for the generic system below. It requires three steps as shown, and they are: find the signal power at the receiver by subtracting the path loss from the transmitted power, remembering the account for antenna gains and feeder losses. The number two is that find the noise power from the antenna and add to this any noise generated within the system. The third number is that calculate the ratio of signal power to noise power. What is not included yet in the above, in order to avoid confusion, is the interference. Transmit earth station. For transmit earth station, we consider antenna gain, power of amplifier, and at uplink, path losses and rain attenuation. Satellite. For satellite, we consider gain to noise temperature, equivalent isotropic radiated power, saturated flux density, amplifier characteristics, and at downlink, we consider path losses and rain attenuation. Receiving earth station. At receiving earth station, antenna gain, low noise amplifier to low noise bandwidth noise temperature can be considered and other requirement. For next slide, Tahir will continue.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I will brief you about the link budget equations. We have a couple of equations to calculate different parameters. The first equation is to calculate the receiver power, which is PR is equal to EIRP plus GRX minus LP minus LA minus LTA minus LRA, where EIRP is the isotropic interior power, LP is the path loss, LA is the attenuation in atmosphere, LTA is the losses associated with transmitting antenna, and LRA are the losses associated with receiving antenna, and GRX is the receiver antenna gain. EIRP is the amount of power that would have to be radiated by an isotropic antenna to produce the equivalent power density observed from the actual antenna in a specific direction. The EIRP is still a function of direction. We are not assuming that power is radiated isotropically. Here in the figure you can see that receiver power is the combination of power radiated isotropically and the transmitting power. To calculate the EIRP, we have the formula PEIRP is equal to transmitting power plus antenna gain minus losses in the feeder, and all these parameters are calculated in dBs. Path loss is the sum of the free space loss, gas loss and additional path losses. Path loss is also calculated by the formula 4 pi d by lambda whole cube square, where d is the slant range. Noise power at the transponder depends upon three factors: the Boltzmann constant, the equivalent noise temperature and the noise bandwidth of a receiver. By summing up these three factors, we can calculate the noise power at the transponder in dBs. Effective temperature depends upon three factors: temperature of low noise amplifier, temperature of TC and the gain of low noise amplifier. The formula to calculate effective temperature is simple. The TE is equal to T1 plus T2 divided by G1. The noise temperature depends again upon three factors: the temperature of antenna, fuel losses and the feed temperature. To calculate the noise temperature, the formula is TS equal to temperature of antenna divided by fuel loss plus 1 minus 1 by fuel loss whole multiplied by feed temperature. The system temperature is simply the sum of the noise temperature and the effective temperature. By simply adding them both, we can have the system temperature. The carrier to noise ratio for a link can be calculated by a simple formula, that is power at transmitter minus the noise power. By simply subtracting the noise power from the transmitter power, we can have the carrier to noise ratio for a link. Now we have a simple example to elaborate the design of uplink. Let's suppose that a transponder of a Ku band satellite has a linear gain of 127 dB and a nominal output power at saturation of 5 watt. The satellite's 14 and receiving antenna has a gain of 23 dB on axis and the beam covers Western Europe. The problem is that calculating the power output of an uplink transmitter that gives an output power of 1 watt from the satellite transponder at a frequency of 14.45 GHz when the earth station antenna has a gain of 50 dB and there is a 1.5 dB loss in the wave pattern between the transmitter and the antenna. Assume that the atmosphere introduces a loss of 0.5 dB under clear sky conditions and that the earth station is located on minus 2 dB contour of the satellite's receiving antenna. Now the input power required by the transponder is simply the output power minus the transponder gain. So 0 minus 127 is equal to minus 127 dBW. Pin is equal to minus 127 dBW. The uplink power budget is given by the link equation, which is PR is equal to EIRP plus GR minus LP minus LWG minus L atmosphere minus L pointing. Simply rearranging and putting the proper losses, we can calculate the transmitted power, which comes out to be 1.2 dBW of 5.2 watt. Now we have another problem, that if rain in the park causes attenuation of 7 dB for 0.01% of the year, what output power rating is required for the transmitter to guarantee that a 1 watt output can be obtained from satellite transponder for 99.99% of the year? The solution to this problem is that we will provide extra 7 dB output power to compensate for fading on the path due to rain. The transmitted power in this case will be 7 by 2 plus 7. equals to 14.2 dBW or 26.3 watt. So the final transmitted power is equal to the 26.3 watt.
Tahir and Vamik has completely described you all the parameters which are considered in satellite link budget analysis. Now I'll be explain you an example which with the help of those parameters we'll calculate the carrier to noise density ratio at the earth stations. In this example we have a downlink satellite saturation that is ARP is effective isotropic radiated power that is equal to 25 dB watt. Output backoff is 6 dB, free space loss 96 dB, and other losses, downlink losses are 1.5 dB. Earth station gain to noise temperature is 4 dB per Kelvin, and we'll calculate the carrier to noise density ratio at the earth station. The formula for this carrier to noise density ratio is in the first line, that is C by N naught is equal to AIRP plus G by T minus FSL minus K minus LM. This is a formula and we'll consider all these parameters in dB. Therefore, we are adding and subtracting them. We know all the parameters that are described in the statement. That is a satellite saturation, earth station, G by T, free space loss, K value of K, other losses, output back off. And after putting all these values in the first equation of C by N naught, we come with the total C by N naught of the downlink, and that is 91. It is a ratio, so we don't have a value. Now coming towards satellite specification, we have a KU band satellite parameters. These are general parameters and must be considered generally. For geostationary at 73 west longitude, we have 28 KU band transponders. The total RF output power must be 2.24 kilowatt, and the antenna gain for a transmitter and a receiver must be 31 dB equivalent to gain G. Receiving system noise temperature is 500 Kelvin, that is TS. Transponder saturated output power is 80 watts PSAT. Then the transponder bandwidth must be equal to 24 megahertz. For a signal with compressed digital video signal, for compressed digital videos signal with transmitted symbol rate at 43.2 MSPS. Minimum permitted overall C by N in the receiver must be around 9.5 dB. These all parameters are generally considered. They are as it is followed. They mean they are used as references point. Now coming for the transmitting KU band earth stations. We have an antenna diameter that is 5 meters deep. Aperture efficiency must be equivalent to 68%. Uplink frequency must be 14.15 gigahertz for the uplink. TK required C by N in KU band transponder must be 30 dB. The transponder output backoff is 1 dB. Miscellaneous uplink losses must be around 0.3 dB. And location must be minus 2 dB. Counter of satellite receiving antenna. Now for us receiving KU bands earth station, we have downlink frequency must be around 11.45 gigahertz. Receiver intermediate frequency noise bandwidth must be 43.2 megahertz. Antenna noise temperature must be 30 Kelvin. Low noise amplifier noise temperature must be around 110 Kelvin. Required overall C by N in clear air must be 17 dB, and other miscellaneous losses must be around 0.2 dB in the receiving. We have 0.3 dB losses for the transmitting, and receiving we must be consider 0.2 dB loss, and for location is minus 3 dB contour of satellite transmitting antenna. For rain attenuations and propagation factors, after a lot of analysis and research, they are found to be for uplink for 14.5 gigahertz in a clear air, the KU band has 0.7 dB rain attenuation in the clear air, and for a downlink in clear air is 0.5 dB. And if we consider a rain rate of 0.1% of year, the uplink rain attenuation must be around 6 dB, and for a downlink rain rate of 0.1% of year must be considered at 5 decibel. we have a complete scenario. We have another scenario. I have chosen it to completely brief you about the KU band using of all the KU band parameters which we have described in the previous slides. These parameters. Then how we will use all these parameters to calculate to have our satellite link budget analysis when we consider a KU band. Now we have a scenario which will consider all the parameters which we have discussed in the recent slides which are about the parameters of the KU band. This slide explains that the example examines the design of a satellite communication link using a KU band geostationary satellite with band pipe transponder to distribute digital TV signals from an earth station to many receiving stations. For the KU band uplink design, the first step is to find out the uplink transmitter power required to achieve carrier to noise ratio for the uplink, which is 30 dB in clear air atmospheric conditions. Noise power is determined first, which is then added to C by N to get the value of C. We have these values for downlink noise power budget. We have a Boltzmann constant in dB watt per Kelvin per hour per hertz. Then we have the value of TS. We have find TS value by adding T LNA plus T in. Then we have a value of bandwidth noise. Then the power noise. Then C by N of the downlink. Then we find the value of C by adding C by N downlink plus N, which is a formula which is from this formula. That's noise power is determined by adding C by N to get C. We have added the noise power. Now we have come with the value of C, that is -113.5 decibel watt, which is equal to the power at the earth station receiver input. We have loud pass indicated as LP. And LP, we have converted LP into dB, and the value of LP is 4 pi r lambda square. We have lambda from C by F. By putting all the values in the above equation, we find the value of LP, which is a path loss, and that is 205.3 dB. The transponder is operated with 1 dB output back off, so the output power is 1 dB below the saturated power. So Psat is equal to 80 watt. Psat is equal to mean it when it will convert 80 watt into decibel watt, that would be 19 dB, and Pt is equal to Psat minus B naught, and that would be equal to 19 minus 1 is equal to 18 decibel watt. Now for downlink power budget, we'll consider the satellite transponder power, which is 18 dB watt, which we got from the previous calculations. Then satellite gain antenna, that is 31 dB. Again, we are described in the satellite's KU band specification. Then the GR, then the path loss, which will we find from this equation, that LP is equal to 205.5 dB. LPT, that would be for earth to satellite on minus 3 dB contour of satellite antenna minus 3 dB. Then we have LM is equal to other losses, which includes 0.25 plus 2.5 equal to dB for the complete budget analysis. Now the miscellaneous losses and absorption in the atmosphere. We have PR, that is received power at transponder. The formula of PR is defined here, that is a PT plus GT plus GR minus LP plus LM plus LPT. We have put all the power all the values from the previous slides, and we'll find the value of PR. PR is equal to GR minus 160. We know the value of PR, and we'll find the value of GR. So GR is equal to 46.5 dB, and when we convert this to the its gain value, that will be 444668.3 watt. Diameter GR, we have the formula for diameter GR is pi d by lambda whole square into eta e d by d square. Putting all the values we know and we simplify it, and we get the value of d, the diameter, and of the antenna, that is 2.18 meter, and it is the diameter of the receiving antenna. Now we'll check the rain effect at KU band in this scenario. we have uplink of 11.45 giga, we have downlink, sorry, we have downlink of 11.45 gigahertz. Path between the satellite and the receiver antenna suffers a rain attenuation of 5 dB for the rain rate of 0.1% of the year. We'll calculate the noise temperature of the in the rainfall. That is T sky rain is equal to T naught into 1 minus G1. The value of G1 must be less than 1. Total attenuation would be attenuation of the absorption plus attenuation of the rain, and its value is 5.5. Now value of G1 is 1 divided by 1 by 10 raised to power 0.55, and it is 0.282. The noise temperature for sky rain is equal to 270 divided by 1 minus 0.282, and it's equal to 194 Kelvin. That is equal to TA minus is equal to TN. We'll conclude that the noise temperature has increased from 30 Kelvin in clear air to 190 Kelvin in the rain. So the TS in the rain is equal to TS sky plus T low noise amplifier, and it would be equal to 194 plus 1110 equal to 304 Kelvin, and when converted into dB it would be 4.8 dB Kelvin. Now the increase in noise power would be delta N rain, and its formula is 10 log TS rain by TS clear air. We'll find the TS clear air if, by adding TN plus TRF, and it would be 140 Kelvin. Putting this value in the increase noise power formula, and we'll get the value 3.4 dB, and which is the increase in the noise power. So putting that value in the C by N for downlink in the rain, and it would be C by N in the clear air downlink minus attenuation of the rain minus increase in the noise power in the rain, and it would be 17.2 minus 5 minus 3.4. So the C by N value for a downlink in rain would be 8.8 dB, and will convert into simpler form, that would be 7.55. C by N downlink in the rain attenuation would be 8.8 dB, and that is when we'll convert it into that simpler form, that is 7.585. We'll see that this C by N is less than the minimum value for the KU band, which is 9.5 dB. So we'll find the maximum tolerable attenuation on trial error method. Let A rain be equal to 4.7 dB. Then the noise temperature for the sky in rain is 178 Kelvin, as we know, and the change in the rain temperature would be then 10 log into 178 plus 10 divided by 140, that would be equal to 3.1 dB. So C by N downlink rain would be equal to 9.36 equal to 9.4, and that is almost equal to 9.5. Conclusion. The above example shows how the link budget can be used to study different combinations of system parameters. Most satellite links analysis do not yield the wanted result at the first time, and the designers must use the link budget to adjust system parameters until an acceptable result is achieved. With this, I thank you all.